Welcome back to quantitative aptitude classes. So as we are aware, we are discussing different topics from quantitative aptitude in various examination point of view. Okay, so in this regard, today I come up with one more topic, name is boats and streams. Okay, this is very important topic in what you can say part of time and distance, we can say, because the concept all the concepts what we used in time and distance are also useful in boats and streams also. Okay, and apart from that, there are four main points are there. Okay, we need to focus on those four points. If you have an idea about those four points, you can able to solve any kind of question from boats and streams. The terminology what I am going to use, it may seems to be something different, but if you catch that words or what he given in the question, what he asked to find, then we can able to solve very easily. Okay, so as I told you, there are four different points, and before going to stress on the four points, we know speed formula, that is speed is equals to distance by time. We have seen in previous episodes, speed is equal to distance by time. Okay, from this formula, again conversion of units, relative speed, okay, average speed, this concept also we are going to use in boats and streams also. Even conversion of units from kilometer per hour to meter per second to kilometer per hour, you need to focus on that concept also. Okay, keep those basic concepts in mind. Apart from these basic concepts, there are certain different points are there in boats and streams, special related to this boats and streams. Okay, now we focus on those points first of all, then we'll start after discussing these points, then we'll start what I can say, some kind of different model problems. Okay, if you understand the problems, basic concept, then you can, there is no doubt you can able to crack any kind of bit from boats and streams very easily. And sometimes we need to use the concept of what you can say, time and distance also, I already told you. Okay, chalo, we will discuss four different points. Okay, in this first point, so first point what is given, if the speed of a boat, see observe here, there are four different points here. If the speed of the boat or a man in still water is x kilometer per hour and speed of the stream is y kilometer per hour in still water, okay, then the four points as follows. First one is downstream speed x plus y kilometer per hour, upstream speed x minus y kilometer per hour, speed of the boat or a man in still water that equal to downstream plus upstream by 2, then speed of the boat or man in still water, that is downstream minus upstream by 2, downstream minus upstream by 2. Okay, these are the points what we need to discuss. Okay, see here, the terminology what we are getting is, one point is downstream and another point is downstream, upstream, and the next one is, let's say, if downstream, upstream given, speed of the man or speed of the boat in still water, okay, or speed of the stream, okay, these concepts we need to stress on that. So all the candidates, so once again observe the concepts, four concepts, what is x here and what is y here, and what is, what you can say, downstream, what is upstream, and all these values. So here x value in the sense speed of the boat or speed of the person in still water, I repeat, so here x value means speed of the boat or speed of the man in still water. Y value is speed of the stream speed of the stream. Here then downstream and upstream. Downstream means what? For example, if the boat is moving along the water direction, for example, water is flowing in a certain direction. See, in that direction only, if the boat or man is moving, then that speed is said to be downstream. And next one is upstream. The name itself is saying. Upstream means what? For example, water is flowing in a certain direction. If a man or a boat is moving against the stream or against that speed, then that speed is said to be what you can say? Upstream, we'll say. Okay, I repeat, downstream, upstream, x value, y value. Here x value means what? X value means the speed of the boat or speed of the man in still water. Here x value means speed of the boat or speed of the person in still water. Y value means speed of the stream, speed of the stream in still water. And what about downstream? For example, if the person is moving, along the water direction, then that stream is said to be what we can say? Downstream speed, we can say. If the person or a man or a boat is moving against the stream or against the flow, then that speed is said to be upstream. There are only four parameters in the chapter: x value, y value, downstream value, upstream value. Okay. Now to find out the formula for downstream is, downstream is equal to x plus y, and the formula for upstream is x minus y. I repeat, downstream formula ds equal to x plus y, upstream formula is x minus y. For example, he given downstream value and upstream value, we have to find out the x value. Then the formula is downstream plus upstream by 2. Then for example, downstream value given, upstream value given, we have to find out the y value. Then we can written as downstream minus upstream by 2. Okay. So these four points once again we'll discuss. Okay. So now we focus on these four points once again, because why I'm stressing is these four points are very essential. Here first point is what we can say? X value. So x means what here? X means speed. Speed of whom? Speed of either boat or simply a person. Okay, finished. Remember always, we discuss this topic with respect to only these four points: x, y, downstream, upstream. That's why I'm keep on stressing on these four points. So x value is that. So now y value. Y value is speed of the stream means indirectly flow speed. Similarly, downstream means, for example, water is moving in this direction. If the water is moving in this direction, then either a person or a boat are moving in the same direction, then that speed is said to be downstream speed, we can say. It is also kind of speed. Or if a boat or a person moving against the stream, then that stream is said to be what we can say? Upstream, we can say. Downstream, one is downstream, next one is upstream. Okay. So now based on this, now we'll discuss formula for x, formula for y, formula for downstream, formula for upstream. First formula is downstream formula. Downstream formula is what? X plus y If it is kilometer per hour, kilometer per hour. If it is meter per second, meter per second. Okay. And secondly, second one is, excuse me, upstream. Upstream is equal to, so formula is what? X minus Y kilometer per hour. And similarly, now X value. So, X value is downstream plus upstream whole by 2. Similarly, Y value. Y value is downstream minus upstream by 2. Downstream minus upstream by 2. So, if you must have heard about all these four formulas. Downstream formula, upstream formula, X formula, and similarly, Y formula. Okay. So, if you observe here, in all the four formulas, there are, in each and every formula, there are three different parameters. Downstream X, Y, three parameters. Upstream X, Y, three parameters. X downstream, upstream, three parameters. Y upstream, so here small correction, it is downstream minus upstream. So, Y downstream minus upstream, three parameters. So, in each and every formula, four formulas, each and every formula carries how many parameters here? Three parameters. So, in the given question, out of three parameters, two parameters, usually two parameters will be given. Out of two parameters, you need to identify what are those two parameters. Then, we have to apply the appropriate formula. Then, we can able to solve any kind of question from both side streams. Before going to start the, bits, we will focus on these four points once again. Have a look. So, what are those four points here? If the speed of the boat or a man in still water is X kilometer per hour and speed of the stream is Y kilometer per hour, then downstream speed equal to X plus Y, upstream speed is equal to X minus Y, speed of the boat or man in still water is downstream plus upstream by 2, speed of the stream in still water is downstream minus upstream by 2. Okay, focus on these four points. Now we will start doing bits. So now we will focus on question number 1. Now we will focus on first question. Here it is the first question. Observe everybody. First question, what is given? A person, right? A person can swim at a speed of 6 kilometer per hour downstream and at a speed of 2 kilometer per hour upstream. What is his speed in still water? What is his speed in still water? I repeat the question. A person can swim at a speed of 6 kilometer per hour downstream and at a speed of 2 kilometer per hour upstream. He asked to find out the speed of the, what he can say, what is the speed, what is his speed in still water. What is his speed means it's similar to speed of the boat or speed of the person. What we have to find, we have to find out the X value. What he given downstream given and what he given upstream given. So, downstream is equal to, here we write what he given, downstream given, right, downstream speed is equal to given, upstream speed is equal to given, downstream speed is equal to 6 kilometer per hour, upstream speed is equal to 2 kilometer per hour. He asked to find out the speed of, the person. He asked to find out what is his speed in still water. We have to find out the X value. The formula for X is what? Downstream plus upstream by 2. Downstream is 6. Upstream is 2. So, 6 plus 2 by 2, 8 by 2. 8 by 2 means how much you are getting? 4 kilometer per hour, or simply what you can write? 4 kmph. It's very basic, simple question, very easy question. Okay. So remember what he given, what he asked to find. What he given, downstream speed given, upstream speed given. What is his speed in still water? What is his speed in still water means x value we have to find out. That is downstream plus upstream by 2. Hence, that is the answer. So now we focus on question number 2. Okay. Now we focus on question number 2. Second question. Here it is the second question. So what is second question? Second question as follows. A boat covers 48 kilometer upstream in 8 hours, 36 kilometers downstream in 6 hours. What is the speed of the boat in still water? And what understanding in the first two sentences what is given? But clearly third line is very clear. What is the speed of the boat in still water? So what we have to find out? We have to find out the x value. Okay. To find out x value, we have to know the ds value and us value, right? So if you can able to find out downstream value and upstream value, then by using that x formula is downstream plus upstream by 2. Okay. But downstream he didn't given directly, upstream also he didn't given directly, he given indirectly. I already told you downstream or upstream is also kind of speeds. Okay. So again we know the formula for speed. Speed formula is what? Speed is equal to distance by time. So here instead of giving downstream value or upstream value directly, he given distance given, time given, distance given, time given. So from that cases we can able to find out either downstream value or upstream value. See, observe first case here. A boat covers 48 kilometers upstream in 8 hours. Okay. So indirectly, what does it mean? 48 kilometers upstream. Okay. He only given distance. He only given distance. Distance equal to how many kilometers? 48 kilometers. Time also given. 48 kilometers in how many hours? 8 hours. Okay. 48 kilometers in 8 hours. Similarly, in second case, what he given? 36 kilometers in 6 hours. So one is related to upstream, next one is related to what? Downstream. Okay. First one is of upstream. This is related to upstream, whereas this is related to downstream. Okay, it's clear. Now we can find out upstream speed. I already told you upstream is also kind of speed, downstream is also kind of speed. That's why speed is equal to distance by time. 8 5s are 40, 8 6s are 46, 6 kilometer per hour downstream. Downstream is equal to 36 by 6. Distance by time, 36 by 6. So here also what I am getting? 6 kilometer per hour. Okay. Upstream value 6 kilometer per hour only. Downstream also 6 kilometer per hour. So this is what I am getting. But what he asked to find? He asked to find out speed of the boat in still water. He asked to find out the speed of the boat in still water. Speed of the boat in still water means we have to find out the x value. The formula for x is downstream plus upstream by 2. Downstream 6, upstream 6. So 12 by 2. 12 by 2 means again what I am getting? 6 kilometer per hour or kmph. Okay. So it's very easy, simple and basic concept. So what we learned from this question? Instead of giving downstream speed and upstream speed directly, okay, he given distance, time in upstream case, distance and time in what you can say downstream case. So hence the answer for this question is 6 kilometer per hour. Now we focus on next question. So now we focus on question number 3, third question. So third question is what? A person takes 2 hours to go 9 km upstream and 2 hours to go 17 km downstream on a boat. What is the speed of the river? Earlier he asked to find out the speed of the boat, but whereas in this question he asked to find out the speed of the river. Okay, to find out the speed of the river, speed of the river or speed of the stream, both are same. Speed of the stream formula means indirectly you have to find out the y value. So formula for y is downstream minus upstream by 2. So do we have downstream and upstream directly? No, because he given again distance given, time given. A person takes 2 hours to go 9 km. Okay, a person, again we'll see, we'll discuss, it is related to upstream, it is related to upstream, it is related to downstream. A person take how many hours? 2 hours to reach how many kilometers? 9 kilometers. Similarly, in second case, 17 kilometers. Again, how many hours? Same, 2 hours. So, time is 2 hours, distance is how many kilometers? 17 kilometers. So, upstream, distance given, time given. Downstream, distance given, time given. Now, we will find out both the speeds. Upstream speed. Upstream speed is, so, distance by time. Similarly, downstream speed, distance by time. Okay, we don't want this. He asked you to find out the what is the speed of the river. Speed of the river means we have to find out the y value. Formula for y value is what? Downstream minus upstream by 2. I hope you are getting what I am saying. Downstream what he given? 17 by 2 minus 9 by 2 whole by 2. Okay, 17 by 2 minus 9 by 2. It's very clear. 8 by 2. 8 by 2. 8 by 2 means how much? 4. 4 by 2. 4 by 2 means, hence the final answer is what I am getting? 2 km per hour or 2 km/h. Previous question, this is somewhat same, but whereas in previous question he asked you to find out speed of the boat, but whereas in this question he asked you to find out the speed of the stream. Okay, so now we focus on question number 4. Now we focus on question number 4. See, observe question number 4. Okay, a boat covers 56 kilometers upstream in 8 hours, 36 kilometers downstream in 6 hours. The speed of the boat in still water is, the speed of the boat in still water is, see, observe last sentence, the speed of the boat in still water. Whether do we need to find DS or US or X or Y? Speed of the boat in still water, it's very clear, we have to find out the again X value. Formula for X is what? Downstream plus upstream by 2. A boat covers how many kilometers? 56 kilometers upstream in how many hours? 8 hours. Okay, 56 kilometers upstream. Now there are again two cases, upstream case, downstream case. 56 kilometers in how many hours? 8 hours. 56 kilometers in 8 hours. And downstream, what is given in downstream? Downstream, 36 kilometers in 6 hours. 36 kilometers, right? 36 kilometers in 6 hours. Now we will find out downstream speed 56 by 8, 8 sevens are 56 kilometer per hour. Downstream, what he given? 36 by 6, 6 kilometer per hour. Excuse me, upstream value I am getting, downstream value I am getting. What he asked to find? He asked to find speed of the boat in still water, right? Speed of the boat in still water. So that is, we have to find out the x value. X is equal to downstream plus upstream by 2, 7 plus 6 by 2, 13 by 2. So half of 13 means what I am getting? 6.5 kilometer per hour, or simply kmph. Okay, this is also one question from this concept. I hope you understood. If you want, you can check it out once again. Upstream 56 8, downstream 36 6, upstream speed is 7, here it is kilometer per hour, it's clear. Similarly, downstream 6, it is also kilometer per hour. So downstream plus upstream by 2 formula, it's clear. Substituting corresponding values, hence my final answer is what I am getting? 6.5. Now we focus on question number 5. Okay, question number 5. What is the question here? A person goes 16 kilometers upstream and 28 kilometers downstream, and each time he takes 5 hours. What is the speed of the stream? A person goes 16 kilometers upstream, 28 kilometers downstream, and each time he takes 5 hours. What is the speed of the stream? Something he given first 3 lines, but observe last line. What is the speed of the stream? So do we need to find out the x value or y value? It's very clear. We have to find out the y value. What is the speed of the stream means? We have to find out the y value. Formula for y is what? Downstream minus upstream by 2. Okay. Downstream minus upstream by 2. Again, downstream, upstream directly didn't given. Okay. Upstream distance time given. Downstream distance time given. Okay. So now we will take the values what he given. Upstream case and downstream case. Upstream case, distance how much he given? 16 kilometers. And downstream how much he given? 28 kilometers. Each time how many hours is taking? 5 hours is taking. Each time is taking 5 hours. So you can able to solve easily. First of all, you need to focus whether downstream or upstream. Okay. Time is same. In both the cases, time is same. How many hours? In both the cases, time is only 5 hours. I think you can able to crack. Take a few seconds, you can able to solve very easily. Okay. Because 16 kilometers, 5 hours upstream. Then 28 kilometers, I think so, 28 kilometers in 5 hours. Okay. So you are going to get the upstream value, downstream value, upstream value, downstream value, then downstream value, upstream value, you are going to get. See, now see the solution is, take a few seconds everybody, my dear aspirants, you can able to solve this. I think you are getting answer. What you are doing? Upstream means 16 by 5. Downstream means what you are getting? 28 by 5. I think so, right? So now what your answer? whether he asked to find the speed of the stream or speed of the boat, speed of the stream, upstream 16 by 5, downstream 28 by 5, y value downstream minus upstream by 2, this is downstream 28 by 5 minus 16 by 5 by 2. So here clearly I am getting 12 by 10. 12 by 10 means this something 1.2 kilometer per hour. Is it same values? Yes, 16, 28. Time is 5 hours. I hope you understood. Okay. So, next we will move to question number 6. We focus on question number 6. What is the speed of the person? What is the speed of the person? In downstream, what is the speed of the person? In downstream is 4 km per hour, and speed of the stream is, its downstream is 14 km per hour, and the speed of the stream is 4 km per hour. What will be his speed in upstream? This is something different. If the speed of the person in downstream and upstream, directly value is given. Downstream value 14 km per hour, upstream value 4 km per hour. Then what will be his speed in upstream? What will be his speed in upstream? So what will be his speed means we have to find out the x value. That too, his speed of what? Just read the question, you will get the idea. Speed of that person in downstream. Speed of the person in downstream, 14 km per hour. Speed of the stream is 4 km per hour. We will write what he given. Downstream given. I hope you understood. Downstream given. Then speed of the stream given. Speed of the stream means y value given. He asked to go find out the what will be his speed in upstream. What will be his speed in upstream? He asked to find out the not x value. He asked to find out the upstream value. So what he given? Downstream speed 14. Downstream speed equal to given 14 kilometer per hour. Okay, then the speed of the stream is, speed of the stream is given. How much he given? 4 kilometer per hour. But he asked to find out the upstream. To upstream formula is what? Upstream formula is x minus y. Y value is there, but is it the x value? No. We have to find out the x value. So downstream formula is x plus y. Substituting corresponding values, substituting corresponding values. So 14 is equal to x value, I don't know, I have to find y value 4. So from this, x is equal to, how much I am getting? 10. It's clear. X value 10 km per hour. I am getting x value. But I don't want x value. Again, he asked to find out the upstream. Upstream formula is what? X minus y. X value, how much is given? X value is equal to given 10. Y value, how much is given? Y value given 4. So 10 minus 4, what I am getting? 6. So units are kilometer per hour. Kilometer per hour. I hope you understood this question. Very easy question. DS given, y given, but he asked to find US. Okay, so in that, to find out the US, first of all we need to find out the x value. If you can able to find x value, you can able to find y value. So here my x value is 10. From that x value, my y value, what I am getting? Y value is equals to, I am getting 6 km per hour. I hope you understood. Okay. Let's, we'll move to next question. Question number 7. We focus on 7th question. Speed of the boat in still water. Speed of the boat in still water is 15 km per hour. See, observe the sentence. Speed of the boat in still water is 15 km per hour. It's clearly x value. Downstream speed is 27 km per hour. Then find the speed of the stream. He asked to find out the speed of the stream. Speed of the stream means what? Y value we have to find. Speed of the boat in still water, x value given. X value given, downstream given, we can able to find out that. Okay. So here we will take the values, corresponding values, what is given? We required downstream, x value, y value, and upstream. So he given speed of the boat in still water. Speed of the boat in still water. That is x value given. X value is how much he given? 15 km per hour. Speed of the boat in still water is 15 km per hour. Downstream also given 27. Downstream also given 27. Then what he asked to find? Then find the speed of the stream. Simply he asked to find the y value. Hence there is no use with y value. Okay, we have a formula. Downstream is equal to x plus y. Downstream is equal to x plus y. So x value, how much given? 15. Y value, how much given? We have to find. Here we know downstream value, right? Here we know downstream value, that is 27. Y is equal to 27 minus 15. 12 kilometer per hour or kmph is the answer. I hope you are getting. Okay, this is regarding that question. So this is also simple basic question. I hope you understood what I did. Ds x y, ds formula, x plus y. 27 is equals to 15 plus y. Y is equal to 27 minus 15. Hence the answer. Okay, this is regarding question number 7, what we discussed. Now we focus on next question, that is question number 8. We focus on question number 8. Here it is the 8th question. Speed of the boat in still water is 28 km per hour. Upstream speed is 17 km per hour. Then find the speed of the stream. He asked to find out the speed of the stream. Something he given in first two sentences. Observe last sentence. Then find the speed of the stream. What does it mean? Clearly, we have to find out the y value. Then what he given? Speed of the boat. Speed of the boat in still water. X value given. Right? X value, how much he given? X value given 28. X value given, y value, and upstream value also. The speed of the boat in still water is 28. Speed of the boat in still water is 28. That is equal to x value is given 28. And upstream value also given. Upstream value, how much given? 27. Sorry, 17. Upstream value given 17. He asked to find out the y value. Formula. Upstream is equal to, is it x plus y or x minus y? X plus, it's not x plus y, x minus y. So x value is there, us is there. Substituting corresponding values. 28 minus y. y is equal to 28 minus 17. So y is equal to what I am getting? Y is equal to, I am getting 11. Excuse me. Are you getting the concept? It's very clear. I already told you. That's why starting of this session, I focused mainly on 4 points. If you observe up to these questions, I am keep on getting x value, y value, downstream value or upstream value. So each and every question is having 3 parameters. Out of 3 parameters, any 2 will be given in the question. So you need to find out the third parameter. Okay, that's why if you can able to find what he given and what he asked to find, then it's very easy, boats and streams. Next we'll see one more question. Next question as follows. Question number 9 we need to discuss. Question number 9. Downstream speed of the boat. Downstream speed of the boat is 30. Upstream speed of the boat is 20. Find the speed of the boat in still water. So downstream given, upstream given, he asked to find out the speed of the boat in still water. Downstream given 30, upstream given 20, speed of the boat in still water. Speed of the boat in still water means what? Speed of the boat in still water means we have to find out the x value. Okay. So downstream, upstream, he asked to find out the x value. Downstream speed given 30, upstream speed given 20, he asked to find out directly x value. The formula to find the x value is x is equal to downstream plus upstream by 2. Okay, we know all. Downstream how much equal? 30, upstream 20 by 2, 50 by 2, half of the 50. What I am getting? 25 kilometer per hour. Okay. So I think you already aware about this. Okay. I don't want to stress on this because the concept is very clear. DS 30, US 20, he asked to find x value, downstream plus upstream by 2. Hence the answer is 25 kilometer per hour. Now we focus on next question. Question number 10, we'll focus on that. 10th question. Speed of the boat in still water 15 kilometer per hour. Speed of the stream is 3 kilometer per hour. A person reached from A to B in downstream direction and come back in 2 hours 30 minutes. How far is the destination? Okay, this is completely something different. So just focus on the question. Question seems to be something lengthy, but concept is very clear. Speed of the boat in still water, x value given. Speed of the stream is 3 kilometers. So y value given. It's very clear. X value given, y value given. A person reached from A to B in downstream and come back means B to A. For that, how many hours he has taken? 2 hours 30 minutes. How far is the destination? How far is the destination? Okay. So this is question something different. Just focus on the question. What he given, what he asked to find. See, we write first what he given, x value given, y value given. X value given 15, x value given 15, y value given 3. Okay, that's it. Nothing he didn't given. X value given, y value given. A person reached from A to B in downstream direction and come back in 2 hours 30 minutes. It's what? 2 hours 30 minutes. So it is 2 hours 30 minutes. how far is the destination? Okay, see, this question is something related to time and distance question. We have seen one question, usually we will see one question time and distance. For example, a student went to school from home at certain speed and again come back with certain speed. Let's say x kilometer per hour, went to school with x kilometer per hour and come back to home with y kilometer per hour. For that, let's say total time is equal to 2.5 hours, or let's say simply in general t hours. How far is the school from home? Okay, usually there is a note in time and distance, that is late late, early early, early late, late early. Based on these four concepts, we have seen some problems in time and distance. So the same formula here also I am going to use, because A to B and B to A, what we observed, distance is same. Okay, to go to A to B and B to A, how much time required? 2.5 hours. Okay, A to B and again from B to A, for that total time is 2 hours 30 minutes, or 2.5 hours. This is simply what he given. So there is a some shortcut formula for this. There is a one small trick for this. The trick is as follows. Okay, observe the candidates, the trick what I am writing here. So here the trick is, he asked to find out the distance. Distance is equal to S1 into S2 by S1 plus S2 into T. Okay, here S1, S2 are the speeds. S1 means downstream speed, S2 means upstream speed. Here it doesn't mean that X and Y. Okay, S1 means up downstream, S2 means upstream. We'll find the downstream separately, upstream separately. Downstream formula, X plus Y, that is 18. Similarly, upstream, X minus Y, what I am getting? Excuse me. So, downstream 18, upstream 12, substituting corresponding values in that formula. 18 into 12 by 18 plus 12 means 30, total time 2 hours 30 minutes. That will convert in terms of hours. 2 hours 30 minutes, 2.5 hours. 2.5 hours can be written as 5 by 2. Simplification, 6 3s are 18, 6 5s are 30, 5 5 cancelled, 2 1s are 2 6s are 3 into 6, what I am getting? 18. Therefore, how far is the destination? How far is the destination? 18 kilometers. So simply you need to focus on this shortcut formula. You need to focus on this shortcut formula. What the formula? The formula is S1 into S2 by S1 plus S2 into T. So this is the how far is destination means 18 kilometers. Here I need to stress one more point. Sometimes in exam, to confuse us, what he will give is, instead of asking how far is the destination, sometimes he may ask, find the total distance travelled by him. Instead of asking how far is the destination from A to B, simply E in this question, A to B, that is destination. So instead of asking the destination from A to B, sometimes he may ask, find out the total distance travelled by him, total distance travelled by him. In that case, what he will do? A to B or B to A, distance is same. A to B, how many kilometers? 18 kilometers. Okay, there is no change in distance. B to A also how much? 18 kilometers. Hence, he travelled total how many kilometers? 18 plus 18, that is equal to how much we can say? 36 kilometers we can say. That is the beauty of this question. If we ask to find total distance, 36 is the answer. But whereas for this question, he asked to find out how far is the destination. So simply 18 kilometers is the 18 kilometers is the answer. Okay. Now we focus on next question. Question number. Okay. We'll focus on question number 11. So what he given? Speed of the boat in still water is 28 kilometer. Speed of the boat in still water. X value given. Speed of the stream is 4 kilometer. Y value given. How far a person can travel in 48 minutes in downstream direction? See, how far, right? Here the keyword is, we are moving to next question. We required question number 11. Speed of the boat in still water, 28. Speed of the stream, 4. How far a person can travel in 48 minutes in downstream direction? So observe once the values what he given. So the values what he given is x value given and y value given. Okay, x value is equal to 28 given, y value is equal to x value is equal to 28 given, and y value is equal to 4 kilometers given. Whether it is upstream or downstream, it is a case of downstream. That's why we will find the value of downstream. So downstream formula, x plus y, 28 plus 4, that is equal to, I am getting 32. Then after getting this downstream, so time also given, how many minutes? 45 minutes. What he asked to find? So how far? Distance. Okay. He asked to find distance. Distance formula is speed into time. Speed means here we should take downstream speed, 32. Time means we should take how many minutes he given? In the question, he only given 45 minutes. Okay. And remember, again it is not there in standard results. Why? Distance speed is kilometer per hour, means time is in terms of hours, but whereas he given in terms of minutes, converting into hours. 15 4 is 60, 15 3 is 45, 4 1 is 4 8 is 32, 8 into 3, how many kilometers? Is it kilometers or meters? No, it's definitely kilometers. Okay. This is the question that is what he asked to find. Okay. There is, we'll see one more question. That is 12th question. Probably it might be last question. Okay. The downstream speed of a streamer is 24 kilometer per hour and upstream speed is 18. How much time will a steamer take to cover 42 kilometers in still water? What will be the speed of the stream? There are two different questions in this. Downstream speed given and upstream speed given. Downstream speed is 24. Upstream speed is 18. So we'll write what he given first of all. So downstream speed given and upstream speed given. Downstream speed given and upstream speed given. So downstream is 24, upstream is 18. 24 and upstream is 18. If you observe last sentence, what will be the speed of the stream? Last sentence, what will be the speed of the stream? He asked to find out the speed of the stream. Y value, for formula, downstream plus upstream by 2, 28 plus 18 by 2, 36, 46 by 2, how much I am getting? 23 kilometer per hour. This is what speed of the stream. So I am getting 23 kilometer per hour, 28 plus 18 by 2, it's clear. But there is one more question involved in this. What it is, how much time will be, time we need to find to cover 44 kilometers in still water. How much time will the steamer take to cover 42 kilometers in still water? So we have to find out the speed of the still water, speed of the still water. That is what I am getting, y value I am getting. I repeat the sentence, last sentence, see, observe. How much time will the steamer take to cover 42 kilometers in still water? So he asked to find out the, time. Okay, just substitute the corresponding values, you will get the idea. So just substitute time, time is equal to distance by speed. So distance is given, how many? 42 kilometers. Distance is equal to 42. Distance equal to 42. Speed also given. What speed? Speed of the stream, 23. Okay. So simplify with 23. Hence you will get the time in terms of, either if you ask you to find hours means hours, minutes means minutes. Okay. So now whatever the model, just focus on 3-4 points, whether x value given or y value given or ds given or us given. Okay. In the question, each and every question, you will be given only 2 parameters, but each and every formula carries 3 parameters. So out of 3 parameters, what he given and what he asked you to find. And if you are able to identify x, y, ds and us, you can able to solve boats and streams very easily. Okay.